That 1997 flood was life-changing for me. I saw the devastation. There were 5 people that lost their lives. We had millions of dollars in damage to homes and businesses. It took years and years to recover from that event. You can see Spring Creek. It's just a little trickle. You can jump over it on most days. But on the night of July 28th, it just kept rising and rising and rising. It was greater than a 500-year event. It was a big, devastating event for Fort Collins. The community really rallied together after the 1997 flood. And one of the key things that they were looking at was, how can we prevent this from happening again in the future?
Out of this tragedy, Fort Collins began to focus on building resilience. The city implemented many powerful approaches to prevent future disasters. One of their first investments was a flood early warning system.
This gauge detects the water level in the river and then can send us that information in real time. In 2013, that flood warning system was vital.
Additional gauges throughout the city and upstream high in the watershed give emergency responders a much better chance to help residents stay safe during floods.
In some places, we're going to build storm sewers. We're going to enlarge bridges to be able to handle the capacity. Other tools are education and outreach. Things like our bus benches and our notices that we send out to residents that are in the floodplain to let them know about their flood risk. The sculpture behind me is a marker, a high water mark sign for the 1997 flood, so that we remember that this event happened, it can happen again.
Flooding doesn't have to be dangerous. During high flow events, rivers expand into their floodplains, allowing water to spread out and slow down. Along its largest river, Fort Collins has set aside 2/3 of the 100-year floodplain as parks and natural areas. Accommodating river flow within floodplains is a smart adaptation strategy. Detention areas far from the larger rivers and creeks allow people to experience wildlife when conditions are dry, while also protecting lives and property during flash floods. Though they can be controversial, regulations can be very effective. The city requires floatable materials to be secured, and they prohibit high-risk building in floodplains along the Poudre River.
The great news is in 2013, for our flood on the Poudre River, we saw very little material floating downstream. We came through the 2013 flood with no structural damage to buildings. That's a phenomenal accomplishment, given that it was a 50-year event. It's important for us all to remember that these things from the past can help teach us about what to do for the future and how to be able to be resilient as a community so we can bounce back easier. Fortunately, our community leaders have been looking for the long term because we know that we're in an area that's at risk. We've been at this since 1980 and we've made a lot of progress, but there's still a lot more to do. We have a lot more areas that still are at risk, and it's going to take more time, it's going to take more money, and it takes a lot of perseverance on the part of the community and a lot of foresight to realize that these things are going to happen, they're going to continue to happen, and we have to adapt.